Okay, hello everybody. For this video, we are to discuss your supplementary material for your audit of inventory. And as mentioned in the LMS, we will also have a little bit of our PSA 501 to supplement yung ano ba talaga yung gagawin natin when we audit your inventory. Ano yung requirements per standard when we talk about observation of inventory count. Let's start. Kung sa cash natin, meron tayong bank record, may proof of cash, may cash count. Sa ating receivable, yung pinaka main or yung procedure talaga na medyo sabi natin na audit procedure natin doon is your confirmation as well as their aging. No, we also do that. Meron din tayong cut-off tests, no? Sa inventory naman, we have observation of inventory count. Okay? Observation of inventory count. Please notice that we are using observation of inventory count. At hindi po count, at hindi po siya in hindi po siya counting of inventory. So we are there, ideally the auditor must be there to just observe the inventory count. So the observation of by the auditor of the client's counting of inventory is generally accepted auditing procedure and departure from it should be justified. Okay? So this is a mandatory talaga na mandatory procedure natin that when pag may count, therefore we need to attend, we need to observe the inventory count, and again, departure from it should be justified. During the observation, the auditor seeks to determine that recorded inventory item does not exist, meaning we are going to address the existence assertion. Yung mga items ba are recorded, meaning kompleto ba the assertion completeness, and that the client has properly considered the condition of the items, which will ultimately affect our valuation. Because remember, if a certain inventory is not saleable anymore, it should be written off, diba? If the inventory is not yet saleable, meaning work in process din siya, iba din ang kanyang pamantayan for the cost of that inventory. So that is why very important that you are there to really look at, to observe na nafa-follow ba yung tamang procedures and tama ba yung principles when they do or when they actually do the observation or the inventory count. Okay? Now, one thing lang siguro karon na that I can share na last July, July ba yun? I forgot. last year na lang, to be general, I attended a 3-week seminar with IFAC, no, the International Federation of Accountants. Every Wednesday, meron silang every Wednesday evening seminar. So I attended there, and tatlong seminar yon. Una is what is audit planning during COVID times. Second day ng seminar was audit evidence, gathering of evidence at COVID times. And the third day ng seminar is audit reporting during COVID times. So parang ganun ang concept niya. And merong mga panelists, merong question, then merong panelists. These are set of persons, known persons, owners, heads, partners of big accounting firms, international accounting firms. So they share ano yung mga naging problema nila, what are the challenges that they have faced, as well as what are their alternative procedures in doing such procedure, especially during audit of inventory, wherein because of lockdown, because of restriction in our mobility, there has been a question, how do they observe or how do they conduct the observation of inventory count? But the absence of the physical mobility opens up the opportunity to do it, through the internet, through the video conferencing. So ginawa nila, okay, set up kayo dyan ng laptop, lagay ng camera, punta ka sa Zoom, then videohan nyo. Ano? Habang kami, nakatingin kami, doon sa office namin, kayo, you are videoing yourself. doing the inventory account. So yung client, naka-account sila doon, may camera, tapos si auditor naman at the comfort of their homes, they're observing the inventory account. So 'di ba? So those are ways na para ma open up or para yung magawa talaga yung observation inventory account, because again, it's very empirical and departure from that observation should be justified. Okay? So when a client uses statistical methods in determining inventory quantities, the auditor should be satisfied that the sampling plan has statistical validity, the existence of good internal control, including the accurate perpetual inventory system, may allow an effective count to be made prior to year end. So, I mean, if the control is good, then pwede tayo mag-count, di ba, prior to year end. In those cases, the auditor shall rely on the internal control and test of updating the inventory through the year end to determine the year end inventory exists and is properly valued. And the auditor may verify the accuracy, no, of the perpetual records by its examination of the RR, the receiving reports, and the vendor's invoices. RR will determine or will represent the incoming inventories. Vendor's invoices will stand for the outgoing na inventories, 'di ba? Pero for a first year client, no, if this is your first year to audit with your client, therefore the auditors will probably not have been present for the count of the begin inventory, 'di ba? So kung hindi ka kung first year client mo siya, so meaning nung ending last year hindi ikaw auditor. So meaning pag carry out ng begin inventory, wala kang knowledge or wala kang evidence about the reliability of the beginning inventory. Okay? So audit, if meron namang other evidence that which is available, no, if you can be able to inspect, no, yung work ng ating predecessor by looking at the predecessor working papers, so there shall be no modification, no, hindi mo kailangan i-modify ang report kung satisfied ka naman. Okay, pero kung walang evidence available para ma-determine kung yung ating inventory ba is okay or hindi, or yung big inventory ba is tama ba yung amount, so the auditor may be required to qualify his or her audit report because of the scope limitation. And if a first year client may be engaged by the auditor subsequent to year end, no, if hinarap ka na after the year end, therefore you have missed the year end inventory counts, anong gagawin mo? So in addition, other events may make it impossible, or there are also other events that will make it impossible for you to be present during the inventory count. Example nga, yung tinatawag natin na yung lockdowns, just like that. So what you're going to apply alternative procedures. No, alternative procedures may sometimes be used to establish the accuracy of the count. However, these alternative procedures should include some physical counts of inventory item and should include appropriate tests for intervening transactions. Ano tong tinatawag natin na intervening transactions? Example, ng timeline natin. Magka-count dapat ang company December 31. Pero ikaw, available ka lang auditor December 28. Okay, December 28. Nalaman mo, no, December 28, meron silang 20,000 units because maganda ka siguro, you noticed that they have effective control, you accepted na based on test counts, meron namang ginawang test counts konti yung client, tapos kinalang kinumpare na agad sa kanilang records, then they generalize it, no, using statistics. So you're satisfied na at 20,000 nung December 28, but hindi December, pero the question, December 21 yung concern natin. Dito papasok ang tinatawag natin na intervening transactions. Intervening transaction, these are transactions that happen between the count date, kung kailan available at yung year-end inventory mo. Okay? So yung December 29 at December 30 na transaction, those are what we call intervening transactions. So, o sige, pulos ani sir, don't tell me 20,000 ibutang ni Mudira. Dili, you cannot put 20,000 na inventory in your financial statement because this 20,000 represents the December 28 inventory. We need to look at the December 31 inventory talaga. So, dito kapasok yung examination natin of our intervening transactions. Wait lang, ha? Okay, balik po tayo. Dito papasok yung ating testing or analysis of intervening transaction. For example, nung 29, meron kang nabenta, you're able to sold, no? Nakabenta ka ng let us say 5,000 units of inventory. Tapos nung 30, meron kang na-receive, merong na-purchase, no? worth of 3,000 inventory. So, anong gagawin mo? So, using the analysis of the intervening period, makukuha mo yung ending balance. So, kung yung December 28, 20, may nabenta na 5, so tanggal yung 5. Tapos, since may pinurchase, may na-receive, so add ka ng 3. So, in that case, you'll be able to know na ay 18,000 yung inventory at year-end. So, that is what we called the tests of the intervening transaction, no? Yung test of the intervening transaction. So these are the typical audit procedures for inventory. So review the disclosure with the compliance with the GAAP po natin. Inquire about kung meron ba silang pledging of inventory and verify the adequacy of the disclosure. Pledging of inventory, 'di ba? Ito yung tinatawag natin na park sale, yung isa sa mga ways when we do financing, 'di ba? Park sale yung doon sa what I mentioned on the other video na park sale, we let our inventory be a collateral sa ating utang. So in that case, kung may pledging, ginawa natin collateral inventory natin, I think it's reasonable that this should be properly disclosed. Review of the sales, purchase, and sales commitments. Okay. Confirm consigned inventory. So again, if a certain inventory is wala siya sa premises ng company, and it is on the custody of a third party warehouse, therefore, as auditor, you need to confirm, no? If meron bang mga consigned inventory, di ba? Uy, consignee, meron bang natira dyan inventory namin? Uy, third party warehouse, how many is our inventory there? How much yung bayan inventory na dyan sa inyo? Okay? Review the CPA's control procedures relating to warehouse man. Obtain the CPA's report for the warehouse man's internal control. Because it's very important yung ating warehouse, the internal control ng ating warehouse, Because this warehouse man has the custody over the inventory. And alam po natin, kung wala tayong inventory, siyempre, wala tayong mabibenta, wala tayong revenue. Diba? So, kung importante yung cash natin in the company that we are putting controls to prevent theft of cash, we also would like to put into controls to prevent the theft of inventory. Observe physical cost of the goods. If warehouse receipts have been pledged as collateral, then confirm with lenders details of the pledged receipts. Observe the taking of physical inventory and make test counts to verify the existence. Okay. Review the cutoff of sales returns, purchases, and purchase return at the year end. So, cutoff testing tayo. Applicable pa rin dito yung cutoff testing po natin. Okay. Perform test counts during the observation of the taking of the inventory and compare them to the client's counts. Okay. Inquire the management as to the existence of consigned inventory to verify the adequacy of their disclosure. Perform annual pro example of this is yung gross profit margin natin by the use of our gross profit method and other techniques such as related inventory method. Account for inventory tags and count sheets, no, kung tama ba, kung kompleto ba yung na record. You foot, no, the summary inventory, paki-foot po ko sa paki, when you total, Please, bakit total kung tarong basi na kulang og 20 basi kulang 20 pesos o ka sobrang 20 pesos, 'di ba? Or baka kulang baka meron kang na interchange done, there will be a transposition of the figures, 'di ba? That's a big problem. Reconcile inventory summary schedule to the GL to verify the accuracy. Test the inventory cost method. No, are they using LIFO or FIFO? Because we're not using any more LIFO. FIFO is the GAAP. Okay, FIFO is the GAAP. Test the pricing of inventory to verify whether it is valid at LCNRV. Diba, remember na inventory LCNRV po tayo. Okay. Examine the inventory quality and condition to assess whether there may be evidence suggesting na unsatisfactory condition yung ibang inventory doon. And additional test in case mayroong mga obsolescence to verify the valuation of the inventory. Baka mayroong inventory na ba na yung tawag na, yung sa, kung sa atin at kung sa operations management pa, those letter B, those inventory which is considered as category C, yung mga inventory na hindi na talaga saleable. Yan ba? Baka obsolete na yun sila and not anymore saleable. So, we might consider writing them off. Okay. So, yun yung totality ng ating supplementary material. But I want to dig further sa ating PSA 501. So introduce ko muna yung PSA 501 natin. Our PSA 501 is how do we gather audit evidence specific for selected items. Okay, these are specific consideration for selected items. So ano yung tatlong items? At ano tong selected items na mentioned dito sa PSA 501? Tatlo po, okay? Una, inventory. First item, ito tayo sa requirement. First is inventory. Second is litigation and claims. Third is segment information. These are the three requirements po. Inventory, litigation and claims, and segment information. Sa inventory, titingnan po natin, let's look at the objective ba. Titingnan po natin yung existence and condition of the inventory. Sa litigation and claims naman, completeness of litigation and claims involving the entity. And last, yung segment information. If you could remember your FA 3, yung financial accounting 3, yung tatlo, yung third na volume ni Valix, diba? That was your PFRS number 8, the operating segment. Ito po yan, na? Yung was the in segment information, yung mga reportable segments are the requirements of PFRS 8 on reportable segments have been properly presented and disclosed in the financial statement. But we will dig sa inventory ngayon. We will reach litigation and claims pag-aabot tayo sa current audit of current liability. Actually, dapat mag-discuss ka tayo ng current liability because kung ating consider yung ano yung transaction cycles talaga, dapat dito sa expenditure cycle magdi-discuss na dapat tayo ng liability. Yung current liability lang naman yung provisions ganon, pero we're following the syllabus kasi. So we are asset muna then liab then equity. Nonetheless, audit pa sa ano tayo, inventory po tayo. When inventory is material to the financial statement, the auditor shall obtain appropriate evidence regarding the existence and condition of the inventory by, una, dapat you must be at the inventory count unless impracticable. And second, you should perform audit procedures over the entity's final inventory records to determine na yung account, yung talaga yung nag-reflect doon sa ating record, sa ating financial statements po natin. So, dalawang gagawin mo ha. Una, you need to be there. You need to be in attendance at the count. And second, you need to make sure na yung account, that's the thing that is reflected talaga in the actual inventory count. Okay? So, attendance at physical inventory count. So, ito pong tatlo. These are the three items. Ito po yung tatlong tatlong requirements under at during attendance of the physical inventory count, hindi po kayo supervisor. Auditors, hindi kayo supervisor. You don't just enter then suguon niyo sa OSIG, ihapan na din, no? It's not your job to do that. It's the management directive. You're just there to observe. Okay? Not direct them. Okay? So, anong gagawin mo? Una, evaluate niyo yung management instruction. Kasi, syempre, yung mga katauhan dyan, they do not just count. Ihap. Sige, tapos balik. Hindi ganun, di ba? Meron silang procedures na pina-follow. And you should check. Now, you should evaluate yung instruction and yung procedures that the management has, no, in recording and controlling the result of the physical inventory counting. Kasi pag if nakita mo na yung procedure and instruction pa lang is medyo topsy-turvy na and medyo hindi logical yung instruction and procedures, I think it will be part of your findings. It will be part of your recommendation. Hindi mo naman sabi, ay, mali din siya. O, kaning i-follow. No. Hindi ganyan. No? Please lang, again, observe lang kayo doon. You are not going to direct. No? Di umanugo dito. Okay? So, evaluate the management instruction procedures. Observe the performance of the management's count procedures. Kung yung mga procedures ba na nakalagay, na-follow ba nila? Also, inspect the inventory. Kaya, inspect mo, titingnan mo, you open the box, kung meron bang, meron tayong tinatawag na hollow square. Okay, hollow square, meaning box, pero why solid? Hollow square, di ba? Yung tinatawag natin, hollow square. Hollow, spelling, sir, ginuo ko. Tignan ko, sulat na lang. Hollow, ano na ba? Hollow square. Basta pa-box-box lang din na diha, no? Pa-box-box lang niya. Wala din sulod. Okay, so, that's what we called hollow square. Okay, so, wala siya din. Basta hollow square pong tawag dyan, no? Ibang hollow square na lumabas sa Bing search natin. Sige, hollow square pong tawag doon, no? Box siya, pero walang laman. Hollow square. And perform test counts. Now, if the physical inventory counting is conducted at the date other than the date of financial statement, in addition to the procedures required in the paragraph form, perform audit procedures to obtain evidence about whether the changes between the count date and the date of the financial statement have been recorded. I think yung what is meant by number ng fifth paragraph is ito, no? If inobserve mo yung inventory, other than the year end. So, you need to make sure na yung in-between transactions have been accounted properly. Number six, if the auditor is unable to attend the physical inventory counting due to unforeseen circumstances, the auditor shall make or observe some physical counts on an alternative date and perform audit procedures on intervening transaction. Yun, same pa rin, no? If hindi mo siya na-count ng December 31, because example, merong suspension of work because of bagyo, unsa ba, no? Bagyo, and tapos resume na tomorrow na lang dapat yung count natin. So, again, so you may, okay lang naman, basta you're able to conduct the inventory count, no? You should observe the counts on an alternative date and perform alternative procedures on intervening transactions. Pero, if the observation became impracticable, meaning imposible, example, ay, may lockdown, may lockdown nga, tapos wala kang ada at hindi ka makaschedule ng ibang time because again, yung lockdown natin is good for how many months. So, ang gagawin mo na lang, you perform alternative procedures. Gaya nung sinabi ko kanina, no? To obtain sufficient, appropriate, or evidence regarding the existence and condition of the inventory. And if it is not possible to do so, then the auditor, you shall modify the opinion because of the scope limitation. And lastly, when again, sabi ko kanina, no, if your inventory is on a custody of or control of a third party, then it's just right that you obtain or you request confirmation from the third party as to the quantity and yung condition of the inventory that was held on behalf of the entity, and perform inspection or other procedures which is appropriate in the circumstances. Kung allowed ka mag-inspect, no, allowed ka ni Klae, okay lang sa third party na mag-inspect ka, tapos with the permission coming from your client, then you may inspect them. Pero for example na, example, bawal nga, the third party itself is not willing to give you access. You see, client naman, okay naman sa client mo, from si third party nga, ayaw niya, because siguro merong mga, merong protocol na gagawin. So you may do other procedures. Mas importante, ito talaga, na confirm mo from the third party yung quantity at condition ng inventory that they are holding. So that's it for our PSA 501 po natin, as well as our supplemental material for our audit of inventories. If there are other questions, please feel free to approach me, to message me. Kung may mga queries and may clarification, message me lang. Thank you everybody. God bless, stay safe, and may God give you peace.